Bloodborne is home to a vast variety of enigmatic figures, my favourite of which being Simon the Harrowed. Simon the Harrowed is an old, blood-drunk hunter. We're never told exactly how long he's been there, but we do know he's been there a very long time. There's so many secrets with Simon that haven't been talked about, and I'm so excited. Now, normally people at the beginning of the videos decide to say, please like and subscribe, but to me that's a bit stupid. They haven't even watched the video yet, and the same principle applies here. You have not watched the video, but if you get to the end of the video and you have enjoyed, please consider leaving a like and subscribe. It truly helps the channel in more ways than one, and it really truly shows me that you are enjoying this style of content. All I want to do is provide good and quality content for games that I absolutely adore. Anyway, without further ado, I hope you enjoy the video. I forgot to mention, sadly, there won't be any of my Simon clips in this video, except for a few. The reason being, I'm on New Game Plus 6, New Game Plus 7. I'm doing this video a day in advance, and I can't get past Ludwig on this higher difficulty. Obviously I could, but it's taking a lot longer than I thought it would, and considering I have to go down to London tomorrow, I just don't have time, so I will have to use someone's walkthrough of the quest as background footage for the bits past Ludwig. I am truly sorry. And I promise you that any clips that are used will be credited properly in the description and the pinned comment. Bloodborne's dialogue holds so many secrets. From the Yharnamite to Eileen to Simon himself, they hold so many secrets and our mysterious, enigmatic bow wielder is no exception. Within 30 seconds of meeting Simon, we already know so much about him. We know that he is a blood-drunk hunter who wound up here after being supposedly killed. Or you could say perhaps he travelled here. It is really unknown. We are not told much about the origins of Simon. Most people infer that he is an old hunter, and perhaps he is, just not part of the old hunters that followed and killed the villagers of the fishing hamlet. You might be wondering, why Gecko? Why? Everything points towards him being that. But you're wrong, because to my knowledge, it never actually states that Simon the Harrowed ever took part in the killing of the Mother Coz and those that worshipped her. Not to mention he's actually quite a nice and chill bloke. Yeah, he can come off as a bit creepy sometimes, but that's just part of his personality, should we say. He seems like an alright, roundabout good person, which really doesn't fit with the whole let's mass genocide a bunch of innocent villagers. I do concur that he could have been manipulating us, but I very, very hardly believe that. He seems angry, as we find out later in his quests, angry at these people who slaughtered the fishing hamlet. To me, there doesn't seem to be any remorse in his voice or on his little bits of face we can see. There just seems to be anger, and if he did commit these actions, surely he must feel remorse, especially considering he's capable of feeling anger. Surely remorse should be in his emotional vocabulary. Perhaps he was an exception. Perhaps he was a blood-drunk hunter who was then killed while on the expedition to the fishing hamlet, and he now lies in vengeance inside the hunter's nightmare, trying to progress forward to enact his revenge. Though that is just a theory. To me, there's no doubt in my mind that Simon the Harrowed was not part of this expedition. But do not take my words as 100%, as nobody, I mean nobody, can be 100% about FromSoftware's lore. It's just that secretive. Not to mention he quite literally says this after we beat Ludwig.
High time someone exposed the whole charade. Now, go on ahead.
We are told all throughout Bloodborne's DLC that Simon wants to end this hunter's nightmare. He believes that us hunters should not be forced to pay for the sins of our forefathers. And by the fact that he calls them his forefathers, basically confirms that he is not part of the group that killed the fishing hamlet. And like a lot of things inside of Bloodborne, Simon has a secret meaning and metaphor hidden within his dialogue. Simon is in fact a metaphor, another metaphor for life. In our last Bloodborne video, which was our last video, we talked about the secret themes behind Bloodborne and how it hasn't been talked about in the 9 years since its release. And while that one ended quite positively, even if the journey was depressing and sad, this one starts depressing and ends depressing. Simon's story is a metaphor for how things can go terribly wrong. Simon quite literally goes into the Nightmare with pure intentions to rid the world and the hunters of this horrible fate upon death. But he fails. Not only is his story a metaphor for failure, it's also a metaphor for the fact that sometimes your best just simply isn't enough. No matter what you do, no matter what actions you commit, whatever actions you take, whatever precautions you take, sometimes your best simply just won't be enough. And from that, you may need to ask for help. And ask for help he did. His dying words were to end this hunter's nightmare and free the hunter's souls. It's truly tragic, and I am genuinely starting to wonder what Miyazaki has been through. So many of his games are depressing, but also show the true face of humanity and the struggles people go through. It's, in a weird way, beautiful. And I just have Miyazaki to thank and the team at Fromsoftware for putting together such an amazing character and such an amazing game. A question you might have is, who is Simon? We've talked about what he's done, what his motivations are, but we haven't talked about his origins. We know that they are mysterious, but there are a few things that we can gather from. For starters, when we finally defeat Ludwig and Simon kills Ludwig's head, he tells us how a great hero Ludwig was. He talks about him in reverence, talks about him as if he knew him, as if he wasn't some meaningless heroic stranger, but a friend, and considering his old attire and his unique weaponry, I would be very surprised if he wasn't from the time of the old hunters, just not necessarily involved in the massacre that we know. Another reason why I believe he's from the time of the old hunters is the fact that Bradur, the church knight, does in fact stalk and hunt Simon relentlessly. Yes, he does the same to us, but to a much more bigger degree than Simon. It makes you wonder why. Now, Bradur's specific branch dealt with keeping the secrets of the church, so is it any wonder that Simon, who's dedicated his whole existence in the Hunter's Nightmare to destroying the Hunter's Nightmare and unveiling this whole charade, as he calls it, surely he would be going after Simon, and he very much does. It was, after all, Bradur who ended up killing Simon in the end. In conclusion, Simon the Harrowed is a truly tragic character and stalks through the Hunter's Nightmare like a vengeful spirit, for he has suffered much under the consequences of his forefathers. His night, though, will come to an end as we finally bring an end to the Hunter's Nightmare and free the spirits of all those entrapped, whether that be the old hunters or the Orphan of Coz itself. The night, their night, has come to an end, and may they find their worth in the waking world upon their rest. Sadly everyone, that is the end of the video. You've watched the whole video now. If you have, thank you very much. It truly means the world. And did you enjoy it? If you did enjoy it, please consider leaving a like and subscribe, as it truly helps the channel. Just wanted to say, before we actually end this properly, how thankful I am for this channel. You lot have been so kind over the last few months, and the growth on the channel has blown me away. We are closing in on 2,700 subscribers, which is mind-boggling. Just a year ago, I was on around 250 subscribers after having made this channel 7 years ago and have been uploading content since then. So to see the channel grow in such a massive way truly means everything to me. As I said, all the footage that I used from other creators will be in the pinned comment and description, and the Discord link will be in the pinned comment and description too. I really do hope you have a great rest of your day, and yeah, I won't hold you a hostage any longer. May you find your worth in the waking world. Goodbye, everyone.